What's up, guys? Today, I'm going to show you how you can create rendered plans in Revit. So the first thing we're going to do is go down here and change the graphics to realistic. Then select the floor, and in the Properties panel click Edit Type. On the pop-up window that shows up, click Edit. On the new pop-up, click on the top column and press Insert. Then select the drop-down where it says the structure and change it to Finish 1. Change the default material and set the thickness of the floor finish. You can see on the preview the floor has an extra layer of material. Press OK. Now, let's separate these layers. To do so, select the floor, and in the Modify tab, click on the Create Parts icon. This will divide the floor into two parts. Next, we'll divide the top part to create different floor finishes for different rooms. Go to the Modify tab again and select Divide Parts. Then select the top layer again and press Edit Sketch. Draw a line where you want the floor to be cut. Make sure the lines extend outward and click the Finish Edit icon. Now you can select that are separate from the rest of the room. To assign material, go to the Properties panel, scroll down and uncheck the material by original option, and select new material for that area. As you can see, the floor finish for that area has been changed. Now, let's do the same for the rest of the rooms. Once we're done, we'll go to the floor plan. Here the changes we made to the floor finish are not showing up. To fix this, go to the Properties panel, and where it says Parts and Visibility, change it to Show Parts and press Apply. If there's still no change to the floor, scroll down on the Properties panel and click View Range. Then on the pop-up window, change the bottom range and the view depth to unlimited and press OK. Now the different floor finishes are visible. I missed one, so let me just change that one. If we change back to a hidden line, you can see all the floor finishes look the same. To add a hatch, select the floor and in the Properties panel, click on Material. Go to the Graphics tab and change the foreground pattern and press OK. Now the floor has a hatch and represents the finishing material. Next, let me show you how I changed the wall hatch to a solid black color. On the properties panel, click Edit on Visibility/Graphics. On the new window that pops up, scroll down to Walls and changes the pattern to solid and the color to black and press OK. As you can see now, the walls are solid black. The furniture is bolder than we need it to be, so let's change that. Select Furniture, right-click on it, and go down to Override Graphics and View. Then by category and on the new window, check Halftone and press OK. This will reduce the opacity of the lines. Let's do this for all the furniture categories. Now, let's add shadows. Go to the Graphics Display option, and in the Shadows drop-down, check Cast Shadows and press Apply. In the Lighting drop-down, adjust the Sun, Ambient Light, and Shadows and press OK. Next, let's adjust the light orientation. Long press the sun icon and select sun setting. In the new window, select a single day and play with the settings till you get the angles you need. If you want a hidden line plan, you can export this and use it in your presentation, but if you want a realistic rendered floor plan, let's keep going. Go to 3D view and turn on the section box. Cut the model to the floor level you want. Then go to Graphics Display Options and adjust the settings as we did for the floor plan. After that, adjust Sun Orientation and Visibility Graphics. Once you're done, double-click R on your keyboard to bring out the render setting. Set the output settings to print with 300 dpi and press Render. When the render is finished, click Adjust Exposure and adjust the settings to the desired look and press Export.